Peter Martin didn't mention that this morning, but here is another idea. A call too late does not disturb his rest. And a call late in the night does not frighten him. You know what? When your phone rings at a certain hour, you're frightened. You just figure it's some bad news. But here's what I'm going to share with you. You can't frighten God. You know why? He's not listening. Before you call, he already knows what you're calling for. So guess what? You can't disturb him, and you can't surprise him, because that's what Jesus does here in this text. He wasn't worried about his personal relationship with him. He was calling his father. At one thing I realized, and remember, when my father was alive, I could call my father anytime. Isn't that right? If you got a good relationship with God, you can call him in the morning. You can call him at noonday. You can call him in the middle of the night. And I got news for you. This is what he said. He said, ask, and it shall be given. He said, seek, and ye shall find. He said, knock, and the door shall be opened unto you. Yeah. Jesus told a parable about a friend at midnight. The man came knocking at the door at midnight. And then the man said, I can't help you. It's too. My family and I are in the bed. But then he thought about it. And got back up and said, let me answer this man and help him out of this situation. You look like you're interrupting me, but you're not interrupting me because you keep on knocking. And that's what God was trying to get across when he said, ask, and it shall be given, seek, and ye shall find, knock, and shall be open. If you don't get an answer on the first knock, some of y'all give up too quickly. Keep on knocking.
This man, this is too long. I'm going to stop this tape.
Keep on knocking.